bad to consider, God is doing the one as well as the other. And that's absolutely true. And you can celebrate that by the joy that we read about in our responsive reading. But going back just a little bit further in the chapter in the book of Ecclesiastes, it says two are better than one because they have a good return for their work. If one falls down, his friend can help him up. But pity the man who falls and has no one to help him up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. I don't know, did any of y'all have that read at your wedding? That's primarily where it gets used, is a cord of three strands is not quickly broken. And there's typically, it's the husband, wife, and God. You can also talk about the Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. But also in the New Testament, where two or more are gathered, God is in our midst. And so that's the part that we can rely on today, is that we are gathered here, and God was already here. And at the same time, we give the praise to him. Approach the very throne of God. So we also talked about a voice that will make it into more than used to. So that's a problem. You asked me if I needed water, and I thought I didn't. That would help. But hell no, I didn't today. So what else do we have going on? We talked about Miss Beck. She's having an eye. I don't know if it's a procedure on her eye. Hopefully so she can see better. She's, I think, 91. So, blessings on that over. And Frankie is having neck surgery Wednesday. I don't know at what time, but I know that that's happening. What else?
First, Casey will be traveling home this next weekend. We found out that Christy said one of her little guys that's in kindergarten that they fell down on Friday, that his little brother or sister, little sibling, was riding along the war with the grandpa and some of them. So that came in.
Yeah, our family from Uganda is scheduled to be here on the 6th, and we're already thinking about all the things that we're going to do and that sort of thing. You don't think about accidents. You think about all the fun we're going to have, you know? And so, yes.
I am appraised that so far, Lawrence Doctor has been finding positive things, and I also like us to pray for when we go back tomorrow. He's going to find more results of stuff, and hopefully, what needs to be done, if anything. He has a new medication which is supposed to help his pain a little bit, and that's a praise as well. And I also like to pray for my friend in California. She emailed me yesterday that they've had up and down temperatures like we've had here. She has a horse who's 25 now, and he had a bad colic yesterday. But he's doing well, and I would just like to pray for her and her sweet horse.
Okay. My business partner's brother had a reaction to a shock, a COVID shot, so he's in trouble right now, so I'd like to pray for him. His name is Mac.
Is it a COVID shot?
I'm not real sure, but he got an infection real bad. He's in ICU in Arlington right now.
I got a couple of phrases. One's kind of self-serving and one a little less. Saturday coming up will be in 10 years that I've been here at Baptist officially. They have this little interim time before the vote. I still got them in the desk, and there was one on the side. I keep that one on top just to remind myself that the one with you. But I tell you what, it's a praise to me. When I was a kid, I never dreamed of being a preacher. I went through firemen and policemen when I was a little kid, but by the time I got older, I thought I'd be lawyer or newspaper. And by the time I got to high school, things were pretty desperate, and I just wanted to get out of there fast and far. It was really my only ambition. So I never wanted to do this. I certainly wouldn't have ever picked me to do this, but it's a joy to do this, especially to do this here. So that's the first phrase. The second phrase is this: I haven't been out here very long, and suddenly the piano player was in a terrible accident, and man, we hardly knew her or her family, but everyone was shaken to the core. And the initial reports was that she might not pull through, and then it was that she might be paralyzed fairly severely, and then it was she might be a little paralyzed, and we've been enjoying that piano music week in and week out. She's not paralyzed at all. I don't think she dances as much as she used to. But it's 10 years from tragedy to miraculous healing. And every time I hear her play that piano, it reminds me that God has the last word, not the doctor, and how awesome and gracious He is. It is more obvious the more we need Him. I'm so grateful that we still have our piano player. I'm grateful for the miracles God has done in her life and through her life. Sorry. Put us on the spot.
I think we should have a prayer, do that, and do your in your daily life. I mean, when you get up in the morning, probably that you expect to see a miracle or to be a living miracle is probably not your first thought. Your first thought may be, oh, I hope I can turn the coffee pot on, you know, something more mundane than that. But are we living in expectation of seeing miracles? We should. Because aren't they happening around us? I mean, just in this congregation here, we've listed several. We're expecting more. We are. And so I think that we should live in expectation and be able to point out where God's hand is on us and moving among us. And one of the other verses is that God has put eternity in our, and He created eternity, thought of it in man. We should be looking forward to heaven. So when the roll is called up yonder, you know, how do you know you're going to be there? Well, it's through a relationship that you have with God here. Because eternity's marching. We're just this little whip in it. And as we pointed out, life can be tenuous. And it can be rough, and it can also be kind of a dance. And there's some good and bad in it. All right, well, that's enough sermon. All right. I just warn y'all, if I ever do that, I'm going to preach it. So.
You want this
list? Yeah, that helped. I've forgotten most of all we've talked about already. So. All right, anything else before we pray? All right, let's join. Father, we thank you that you you've invited us to talk to you. And your word says that we're two or more are gathered, you're in our midst. So you are here before us. And you stand at the end of time knowing that this event was going to happen, that we would be able to talk to you this very day. But we can talk to you about Frankie, who's having surgery, and she, or at least Danny's on the road this weekend, and we pray for safety for him, and we pray for an amazing touch from her surgeon, and healing for Frankie. The same thing with Miss Beck. I mean, she says it's a minor procedure. It's always major to me. But, Father, I mean, great skill for whoever is performing that procedure for her. For Casey, who's going to be traveling home next weekend, and then the family to be riding a lawnmower with your grandpa, and something happened, and the child gets healed, and that's an amazing heartache for all of that family. So I pray you protect them, lift them up, and just cover them with your love. For Norm, we're grateful that we're able to offer praises that his doctor is finding positive things, and we pray that will continue. For Linda's friend in California and the up and down she's had with her horse and that relationship. For
my
Chris's friend who's had a bad reaction, who's in ICU, Father, look down on him and heal him and restore. And assuming you have a family, but bring them all together and make that a positive thing. And we thank you for Jeff and his leadership and his pastoring. 10 years. That's a pretty amazing thing when you consider that the average life of a Southern Baptist preacher is 14 months. Mm-hmm. So, hallelujah. And for Sheree and Brent and all that they went through. And we thank you for that. But we also thank you profusely for the joy she brings to us as a congregation. So, Father, this is much, but we know that you can handle everything. And so we have a great assurance for that. But we also are excited that we get to return a portion of what you provided us to you in the form of offerings. We pray for how that's used. And we also pray for Jeff as he will be preaching to us in just moments. So, Father, take all of the